How do you say that word? Folks or folks or folks? Funny word. But anyway, we're gonna be finishing up these two paintings that I've had here for a couple days, not too long. And actually, I think just 2 days ago, literally just a couple days ago, and finished them up so that we can continue on. There is a chance and a possibility that I won't feel like they're complete tonight. But definitely, we're definitely going to do some major touches at this point. So just throwing on some gloves right now. And this one on the left, as you could tell, is if you're reading the title of this video, that this is probably Sien under umbrella with girl, and this one is farmer sitting at the fireplace. And I'm guessing you probably could have deduced that, but just wanted to share. And both of these paintings are based on drawings that Vincent van Gogh had made at one point. So as of right now, I am painting them. I decided to make them into paintings. And that is my personal project here. While we're at this, right now, just to keep you updated, we are opening up some of our painting supplies. Popping open the painting supplies to keep our brushes clean and such. And one thing about painting is, oof. This quite some strong smells, even if you're using odorless mineral spirits. But fortunately, I do have a lot of ventilation in this apartment, so it turns out okay. Does not turn out too bad. And with that said, let's go ahead and get started on this painting. So let's start with the one on the left. We're going to be working on both at the same time. Let's see what kind of brush we want to start with. Oh, that's weird. This one has like a hair. Oh, this one has a very long piece sticking out of the brush, which is very unusual. But let's see, okay, gotta find the right brush here. All right, found it. So, how's everyone's day? Hope you're all doing fantastic today. I'm gonna be working. Let's see. So this is a nice like thin brush, nice little round brush. It's a bit thinner, and we're just gonna work this into our painting. But what I also want to do is add more detail into the gentleman here. So I'm gonna take this brush as well, and we're gonna add some details. Actually, I have the wrong setup on my screen right here. Let's go. Let's get the right setup up. So we're gonna start with our guy. Our farmer. And what's our farmer doing? There we go. So let's play with our farmer a little bit. Want to add a little bit more. Oh, cool. The paint is still wet, which is fantastic. So some of this paint is still wet. We're going to give him color in some of the hair right here. Throwing a little bit of this brown. Seems like we'll leave that for now. And here, let's go ahead and add some streaks around our, you know, just adding in things as we see them. So little streaks of little streaks of detail here. Go. Next step is to brighten up this color. Let's color the area and really formulate his eyes and nose as we go here. Really just going by what we see. Adding in some darker shadows to help formulate the nose. Now that I'm looking at it, I think this hat could be quite a bit bigger. So let's give an opportunity to enlarge this hat here. I'm gonna do that with So one thing about working with oils is that you have a lot of opportunities to like go back and work on things after it dries. And that's what we're doing right now. This face just, it's not clicking with me, so I gotta figure out how to really tighten this up. I like the left side. I like this left side, but the right side just is not working. So maybe if I add some highlights. let's add some highlights. We'll use this dark brown here to make sure we tighten up the area around his head. All right.
Right.
Later.
Later.
Huh?
I'm hoping to be home by 10.
Okay. Last another one?
Almost. These can't be on the edge.
What can't?
My glasses.
Your glasses?
I'm not saying you did, but...
Your glasses can't be where?
The breakable stuff can't be on the edge of this table.
Okay. Did I put him there?
No, I don't think so.
Huh?
I probably did.
Oh, okay. You should probably write a note to yourself. Do not put stuff here.
Clean it up.
Huh?
I don't even have time to clean it up now.
Well, next time.
No, I have to clean it up. Big puddle.
But you don't have time.
Well, I'm late.
All right, you done getting mad at yourself? You're making puddles of mud.
Well, because I guess there's dirt on the bottom of my shoe and I'm stepping in it.
Oh, jeez. Well, that's not good, huh? If you know it, don't do it. I'm going to paint those in the back a little bit darker. Let's reform this brush. I'm gonna put this brush down. Let's do something about this space. Okay. I'm gonna go. It's a good color for these. Very muted. Like a muted orange. And we're gonna go to get the muted color. Let's add some gray. Go. That's a good color. I like that. A little bit of brown in the middle, a little darker in the center. Okay, that covers some of the darker areas, so let's bring in some of these lighter areas. Now this room's gonna have some light spaces, so one on the top. All right, and these are going to be a bunch of twigs and sticks, so let's get some twigs and sticks going. This is going to be a nice big area of twigs and sticks. Mix some colors in here. Let's experiment with our colors on these.
Let's bring this down to a smaller brush.
Anytime I do some of his paintings, I think about how tragic, you know, that the lifestyle he lived. And all he wanted to do was be a successful painter. That's all he wanted, Vincent. And when I say he, I'm talking about Vincent van Gogh. Let's see. So let's get more of this. Let's get some more. What I need to do actually is I also got to fill in this space right here. Let's get some yellow with the green. A variety of colors. I'm gonna experiment, just kind of values, different shades, different. Let's go another one. Go right here. I think we need some stones in here that are colored. Let's get some fire going underneath. Some of this red underneath. Another stone right here. Looks like there's some more random twigs coming back here. Let's make sure we capture that. Ah, here's where I have something wrong too. This is not a... Alright, slowly getting there, people. Let's do something else here. So we need like a steel gray. Get the steel gray. That's gonna come. So I have to add the details on this baby. Okay. I want a little highlight up in this corner. Add a variety of details, and let's highlight this edge over here. Add a little bit of red highlight at the top of this. Just for effect. And start forming. Okay, let's see. Go. Now we're going to add another layer of this so that this starts to hang. So
know, it's coming along. This is starting to make some more sense. Except, I'm just gonna keep going with this. Add a final little dark area. Need a little bit of contrast with this and the rest of this, but. All right. Let's add a little bit of highlight to this thing. So I highlight a little bit of the top. A little bit of highlight over here, just to give it some design. Get me some more white here. Gamblin 1980. That's what we're using right now. So this brick probably needs, I'm constantly looking at new ways, new things to improve. But this brick probably needs some design on it. I think the funny thing about this painting is that it's really hard to tell where the light's coming from. Hey, what's up, ATG drummer? Hey, you started an art project for school. I don't know if you're still here. There wasn't many people sticking around before you, so I wasn't really paying attention to chat. But hey, that's awesome. You started an art project for school. Hope that's going well. Tell us about it. What's it about? What are you doing? What class is it? I'm guessing it's an art class, but you know, share some specifics. ATG, tell us what's going on. Let's hear. Going on adding some highlights now. So we're gonna start to add some brighter colors here. Stoking some fires. There's gonna be some bricks back here. Some red brick. Probably needs to be some sign of heat, which can be created with color. Make a family tree from Adam and Eve to Jesus. A family tree from Adam and Eve to Jesus. So you have to make that, or is that just what you chose to make? Sounds pretty fun, though. I mean, you got a lot of work ahead of you. Or maybe not. Maybe, you know, you can trace it directly all the way up because your family has a, you know, direct line. That'd be pretty cool, too, if you did. For sure. So, yeah, let's hear more. Do tell. Share more about what you're working on. Let's see. Have to. So how many people do you think that goes back? A family tree. Okay, so are you saying your family tree, like your family tree to Adam and Eve, then to Jesus, or just strictly from Adam and Eve to Jesus? That's pretty creative. I mean, I don't know what the sources you can find are for that, but sounds like a very creative and ambitious project. So, you know, props to you for taking that on. Sounds exciting. Yellow is such a good color for fire. Let's add a little bit more. I think I'm being a little stingy with paint here. I don't want to be too stingy with my paint. So really make it look like these flames are getting fanned. Maybe add a little bit of red. A little bit of red here. Just a hint of blue. Let's get some blue at the bottom. No, too much. Painting winner ornaments, done 7 out of 16. Second one's pretty easy. Hey, cool, awesome. Hey, that is really good if there's like a creative project that you have to do that you find easy. I mean, that's like a great, you know, like, I don't know if it's a starter project for you, because you haven't really shared like other work that you've done, but it sounds like, you know, if you're saying it's easy, that's darn awesome for you, because I'm sure there's some other kids in your class that don't find it easy, you know? They're probably like, how do I do this? How can I possibly make this happen? And there's probably some kid in your class that's thinking that. And you're gonna do it, and they're gonna be like, whoa, how did you achieve this project? How did you make it look so easy? And they're gonna just be in awe of you. So that's pretty awesome. Congratulations on that. And then are you doing any
Any like personal projects, like just for fun and not waiting for like a teacher or. Not really. Hey, that's cool too, you know? Chose to paint others or doing posters. Well, hey, yo, congratulations. I mean, you're doing something different than what everybody else is. And, you know, here's another question for you. You know, just for creative thinking purposes, this isn't, you know, part of your assignment or anything, obviously, but just for creative purposes, you know, it's the brainstorm right now. What other ideas have you come up with? Besides painting, I mean, did you come up with anything else? And maybe you just didn't have the supplies, or just realized you just wanted to paint? How did you come to decide that you wanted to do a painting rather than, you know, any of the other stuff that everyone else was doing? I think that's all part of the creative process, you know, like it's a nice part of the creative process. And let's continue on with this. Fire can be really hard to do if I'm being too conservative with paint and stuff. Let's get some of these hands. Are you taking on art as your main career, or do you have a second job? Well, yeah, I have, I'm an actor too. So that would be a part of my career for sure. But yeah, art is definitely a thing that I will be pursuing from here till eternity. For sure, or for however long, right? Eternity is a very long time. Yeah, I'm gonna be working on this for as long as, you know, until, I can't say like forever, because, you know, I'm 33 years old. I've had a lot of phases in my life where, you know, I thought I wanted things and, you know, it didn't end up being what I really wanted. So just in consideration, you know, changes happen, but for now, yeah, this is definitely creative careers. Creative careers are where I thrive. And that's definitely at least one conclusion that I personally had to self-discover. This idea you know, I've worked in corporate before, and what you find is like every single day, month after month, there's like routine, and it's okay. Like, you know, I was doing very well in that environment too, but at the same time, you know, sometimes you want to do other things. You want to create your own projects. And interesting enough, a lot of people that I ended up working with, they found very interesting careers afterward. They became entrepreneurs. Started like small businesses, so there's a lot of opportunity to explore after you've had, you know, after you've at least attempted to pursue some sort of regular job. I don't know if that was like rambling or anything, but I hope you got the idea there. I'm trying to do this painting at the same time, so All right, my teacher said, are you taking art? Just said I would get 100%, get 100, and if you did a poster, you'd get a 90. Oh, cool, yeah, hey, congrats. If you're an actor too, that's awesome to hear. Yeah. That is awesome that you are also pursuing the creative path, and you know, I totally wish you success along that way. So how's that going for you? Are you making plans? Do you have a momager, like a mom that's a manager, or a dad that's a manager who helps to manage your everyday business affairs as an actor person? Or do you manage your own business? Are you fortunate enough to be able to do your own thing and do well in that? Okay, cool. Hey, local stuff is great. That's how you got to get started. Good way to get started. All right, let's see. I like most of where this is right now, actually. I don't feel like just... Local stuff. Hey, so what's your goal? Are you looking to be in film and TV, or do you want to move into just stay strictly Broadway theater? I mean, you're a drummer, right? You're a drummer, an ATG drummer. So how's that working out? You're doing all the arts, huh? It's awesome. I just met somebody yesterday who was also an actress, actress, musician, voice actor. She had a lot of great skills. Very impressive. It's awesome to have a lot of talents, because no matter what you end up doing in your life, you know, you're always going to have that thing that can help you maintain a level of happiness, which would be the creative work. Let's add. Here we go. Continuing on. Let's find. There we go. We are getting our hand pieces here. Oh, so you didn't even want to be an artist? I mean, you know what? No matter what, whether you're saying, you know, you're interested in art, or you want to be an engineer or whatever. I don't know how old you are, but I definitely think that, you know, it's good to have your goals set right now. That's awesome. That's, you know, 95% of people won't do that. And especially since you're literally typing it, that's gonna have a better way of helping you reach your destination. At the same time, you know, it's cool that you get to pursue stuff while you're still in school, and then, you know, make that final decision of what you really want to do and be able to focus toward that end. So that's awesome. Congratulations. You're very fortunate to know what you want to do. So how was your you know what, that's awesome. Good to that's a good age, and you have a lot of time to think about what you want to be. Very cool. You know, there's an organization, I don't know if you ever heard about it, you should talk to your parents about it first, but there's an organization called Big Brother Big Sister, and it's like a place, I don't know if you have any siblings or older siblings, but there's a group called Big Brother Big Sister or whatever, and basically you can like hang out with like mentors who, and it would have been good for me to know this because I was actually an only child, but if you don't have any brothers or sisters or siblings to like hang out with and stuff, that's a pretty cool program. They let a lot of young people get to connect with big brothers, big sisters that they might have never had. And I think it's a pretty great organization, but worth it if you want to. You know, maybe you'll find an engineer mentor or whatever. Huh, this face, my goodness. This is face that I need to adjust. I love looking at Vincent van Gogh's like earlier drawings because you could see that he was pretty bad at painting faces. Embarrassingly bad. Because all his early faces are pretty much erased. But that's a really good goal though, to be an engineer. That is a very fine goal. Very fine choice you've made, fine decision. It's a very fine choice. So congratulations on that. I know your parents must be very proud of you. What shall I do about this face? Oh. Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. So So how are your paintings coming along? You did say you're done with 7 out of 12, so that must mean are you just drawing like squares? You know what I mean? Like a family tree has like a square with someone's name on it, or is it actually like you have to draw something out like... like what you think the person looked like? A real 4-foot tree. So you have to make 12 4-foot trees, or you're just making a few? So it sounds like a very ambitious project. 4-foot tree, or the just 1 4-foot tree, and you just have to like build around it. That's cool. That's gonna look really cool. That's gonna be photo worthy once you finish it. Make sure to save it when you're done. I have to hang the wooden ornament on it. All right, cool. So what makes you want to be, what was the other thing? You said you wanted to be an engineer. Wow, that's great. Engineer or something. Engineer. Oh yeah, detective or engineer. That's so cool. So a detective, like what kind of detective? What sort of mysteries do you want to solve? Cool, the big stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of very important mysteries that need to be solved. So do you have any like favorite detective stories? Or my favorite story growing up as a kid was Hardy Boys. I don't know if you ever heard of the Hardy Boys. I used to read all their books. All the Hardy Boy books. Have one series that you really like. Cool. Yeah, Hardy Boys is like from the 1980s, so you know, it makes sense that you might not have heard about them. But I don't know, I mean, I don't know what's available nowadays. I'm sure you got all sorts of stories that that are appealing. I used to play this game called Carmen Sandiego. It's called The Magisterium. Hey, that sounds pretty intense. That sounds like a fantasy book, though. Doesn't really sound like sounds more like a fantasy story rather than a mystery novel. That's cool. I mean, either way, I'm just... it's all creative. Reading is very good for you. Kind of like Harry Potter. Okay, cool. So it's like a mystery Harry Potter. That sounds like a great story. Yeah, Harry Potter is amazing. I guess the Magisterium, that's the popular story. I imagine they'll probably make a movie of it one day, if it's good. I can only imagine that somebody out there is planning to make a movie of it right now. Wow, congratulations. You've gotten through 4 books. You get to, like, write book reports on them? Go into some of these spaces. You're gonna go into some of these spaces and tighten up. Our rings to give them some. So here's just here's some art talk right now. Just getting into giving our pieces, our things here, an overall form. So how you create form on a artwork is by being able to understand where the shadows and the lights go. And if you can just do that, you can do pretty well with shadows and stuff. Or you could do pretty well with creating shapes that are 3D objects. And all you need to do is just know what the form is like. I guess no, I don't know why. It's hard for me to talk and paint at the same time, but to know where the shadows and the lights are on an object is what I meant to say. When I get distracted, it's hard for me to point out exactly details, but hopefully you get the idea. So if you draw an object, then you can just see where the light is hitting it and where the shadows are. Can make almost anything look basically 3D, or at least make it look like you know how to make it look 3D. Yeah, well, you know what? Sometimes it takes time to build up a reputation in certain things, you know? That's okay. It takes time. I also don't promote myself too much, you know? Like, I know some people, if they're about to live stream, they'll go on like Reddit or something. And they'll like tell people, hey, I'm about to go live. Check this out. But I don't really spend the time to do that. Well, I probably should. All right, the only thing that's bothering me now, and I know I need to do, is the face. If I at least get the face taken care of right now, I will be happy with what I've achieved tonight for this painting. So let me work on this face. What I need is some darker darks. So I need to stop being scared. And, you know, I'm sharing my inner thoughts here. This idea of, you know, when you're painting, you know, you're constantly going through this decision-making process of how dark to paint something. Fear. You gotta conquer your fears. This isn't like a, you know, debilitating fear or anything. This is just like a, you know, surface level, like, oh, I don't want to mess this up type of thing. There we go. I think we're getting some progress now. Let's go into lighter skin tone. We're gonna put that up here. Yeah, drawing faces is definitely quite the challenge. But that's okay, you know, when you do the things that are hard, that challenge you, every time that you choose to do them, you get better and better. And, you know, I don't mind drawing faces anymore. It's the steady hand that's required for painting small faces that... It gets me sometimes. And you know what? Keep challenging yourself, keep pushing yourself to improve on everything that you don't like to do. Like, I just ran my first marathon this last year, so 26 miles. And I learned a lot from that experience. I'm very glad that I did it, even though it was very difficult and challenging. Maybe I should give him some red lips. I gotta add some pink. There's too much yellow. See, if you study something long enough, you'll find an answer as to what you are doing wrong. And I think that answer just now is that I have way too much yellow. What it needs is a little bit of red. You can't have a face without any red. Too pink, so we're gonna lighten that up a little bit. Maybe add a little green. I think I'm almost done. What do you think?
Almost finished here. Except for this face. I don't mind it not looking right, but I wanted to there's something that I gotta do that I'm missing that needs to be achieved. I just can't quite put my finger on it. I mean, obviously I could spend forever trying to like paint the exact details, but you know what? Let me take a break on the head. And I'm gonna go into some of the hands here. Let's go into the hands. Take a break on the face. Get some of these details. Some of these details around the hand. The hand here. Some of the details in the fingers. Let's see. That's a really weird thumb he made, but let's go with it.
Okay.
Almost there with this. This.
All right. We're almost done here. Let's add a little bit of a light around the top of this thing.
there. Light around the edge, around the top. Continue working this face. One shade darker than that. Let's go one shade darker than that. Okay, let's go here. I'm gonna add a bit of gray. You know what? We're going to go with this. This is it. I just got to add a signature here and we'll be good golden. We're going to go with this as our complete project. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I actually like it this way. Let's add a signature and we'll be good to go.
Oh well, we'll leave that. I actually like the face having this like interesting swirling design.
I think it's complete here. Voila, we are on to our next painting. We're going to be working on this piece right here. And this is almost pretty much done too. Except we just have a couple items I need to work on. And actually, we're gonna, right after this, we're gonna start on a third painting. We have space. Alexa, what time is it?
The time is 8:13
p.m. 8:13, okay. Let's go to another one. Looking at my references. All right, we're gonna be working on this one right now. Let's see what we wanna do for her. I need to get myself a collection of really, really thin, small brushes. Here's the interesting thing is, you know, as my way of progressing as an artist is more and more I want to do bigger and bigger paintings. So I'm almost done with all of my paintings of this size, which would be 11 by 14. And eventually I'm going to move into, you know, the next size up, which is going to be totally different. But for now, next size up, I think, is a 12 by 16. So I'm going to move up an inch in width. And let's tighten up this face here. Yeah, a little bit darker. Give her a little bit of a red lip. This needs a little bit more, not red. Probably needs a little bit more pink in the face. Just a little bit of pink. Let's add some pink in her cheeks. There's so much, Let's come around. This is such a versatile brush because once you throw a little bit of paint on it, it can totally take just about any shape you really need. Oh my goodness.
It's a hint of green. Go this fine detail brush and fix this up.
Let's give her a belt. What kind of belt should we give her? It's gonna be a blue belt. Let's give her a blue belt. Bring back this brush right now. Like a dark blue belt. Let's do that. No, this is, I can't tell if this is part of the dress or a belt. So we're just gonna go with a belt.
Okay, let's see. Get these shoes a little bit of a shine here. Give these shoes some more character. That's what they need. It's supposed to be raining, so let's go for, see how this goes.
And there we go, a little illusion of rain there. So with that, we're gonna call this one complete as well. Actually, you know what? Still got a couple things that I do. Let's go for straight edge. Too thick. Yeah, that doesn't look too good, so I'm gonna try to clear this. I'm gonna put this area in a shadow.
Turn this into grass. See how we can do that. Oh, no. Too wet right now. Alright, how does that look? Yeah, that's alright.
So we're gonna go with that. Okay. No, let's go for one more painting. So these are two of their previous projects. I want to do one more. Okay. So which painting should I put up? I think we're going to stick this one. Let's put this one up here. Let's start our next one.
my signature on this. My signature.
Orange. We'll go with the red. All right, here we go.
Let's start our third painting, and we are actually gonna do what we used to do, and that is actually lay down a lay down an underpainting. Let's go red. Some, a lot of yellow, a lot of red.
Just so we have something underneath, some color underneath to work with. As we start our next project here. And let's see, how do we want to begin? So I'll start about halfway. Nice loose blue as our piece here.
Let's do this. Go with the loose green on the bottom here.
Okay. That looks kind of interesting. Be a little loose with this one.
Start with some brown hairs. Let me try blue now. Some huge feet for a kid, but that's what was drawn. I guess the chair leg ends right around here. So we're gonna go expand upon this. I'll get what I'm seeing here. Let's go tree here. right, with that, we're gonna call this a break time. Good time to go do something else. And with that, this is our painting session for the day. For those of you that tuned in, thanks. Those of you that are still watching, good to see you, good to hear from you. And we're gonna call this a done. Thank you and have a great day.